हेलो प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट है दिले। हेलो
हेलो प्रोग्राम इपो स्टार्ट ही हूँ। माथ्यू सर शैल बी स्टार्ट।
ഷിബിനെ ഷിബിൻ ഹലോ ഷിബിൻ കേൾക്കുന്നുണ്ടോ? ഹലോ ഷിബിൻ, അപ്പൊ
അച്ഛ കേക്കാം
നമ്മുടെ പാർട്ടിസിപ്പൻസിനോട് ആവശ്യമില്ലാത്തവരൊക്കെ അവരുടെ വീഡിയോ 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 ഓഡിയോ അൺമ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ പറയാം കേട്ടോ.
ഓക്കെ
മ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ പറയും, മ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ പറയും. പല മ്യൂട്ട് ആവശ്യമില്ലാത്തവരുടെ ആരുടെ ഓഡിയോയും വീഡിയോയും വേണ്ട.
ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ ഗുഡ് ആഫ്റ്റർനൂൺ. Some general instructions. The participants are requested to mute their audio and video during the presentation. Please don't unmute the microphone and interrupt the session when the technical session is going on. Thank you. Tell me, sir, can we start? Am I audible?
Yes, you can start.
Abhilash sir, are you ready?
I'm more than ready.
Okay, thank you, sir. Shall we start? Okay. Good afternoon. North American first black multimillionaire, American famous American talk show host Oprah Winfrey used to say, "Don't worry about being successful, but work toward being significant and the success will naturally follow." A very good afternoon and warm welcome to all the participants joining today's international webinar entitled as Entrepreneurial Mindset, organized by the Department of Physics with Applied Electronics in association with Entrepreneurship Development Program under the aegis of IQAC Kuriakose Elias College, Mannanam. We have participants joining across India and abroad as well. Thank you all for joining. I would like to invite our student coordinator, Ms. Nivedya Raj, to combat the program. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. It is my immense pleasure to compare this wonderful webinar on the topic Entrepreneurial Mindset. Let us begin with a few lines quoted by the famous American investor Warren Buffett. "It takes 20 years to build a reputation and 5 minutes to ruin it." If you think about that, you'll do things differently. Such great, inspiring words quoted by Warren Buffett. So now, I would like to welcome our honor dignitaries, our principal, Dr. Bridget Paul, ma'am, our vice principal, Father Xavier C.S., IQAC coordinator, Dr. Matthew T. Thalisar, course coordinator, Professor Johnny Thomas, sir, HOD from the Department of Physics with Applied Electronics, Mrs. Deepthi S. Nair, ma'am, program coordinators, Ms. Sonia N.V., ma'am, and Ms. Divya Joseph, ma'am. Also, I would like to welcome our eminent speaker, Advocate Abhilash Thomas, sir, Chief Executive Officer, Indus Viva Health Sciences Private Limited, Bengaluru. Now, let me invite our HOD from the Department of Physics with Applied Electronics, Mrs. Deepthi S. Nair, ma'am, for the welcome speech.
Hey, ma'am, good afternoon to all. Respected Principal, Dr. Bridget Paul, Vice Principal, Dr. Father Xavier C.S., Chief Guest of the Day, Advocate Abhilash Thomas, College IQAC Coordinator Dr. Mathi Twitterly, NAC coordinator Dr. Sandhya C, and our course coordinator Professor Joni Thomas, my colleagues, teachers from various institutions, participants, and my dear students. We are delighted to have all of you here with us to participate in the international webinar on entrepreneurial mindset organized by Department of Physics with Applied Electronics in association with ED Club and IQSE of Kuriakose ABS College Manana. Let me welcome you all to this program. And Advocate Abhilash Thomas, CEO of Indus Vibha Health Science Limited and the trustee of Indus Vibha Educational Trust. He's a man with great vision, an entrepreneur with a great belief that commitment and optimum utilization of sociocracy builds the cornerstone of any successful business. A hearty welcome on the behalf of the entire KE family, dear sir. So I would like to welcome our respected principal, Dr. Bridget Polman. We are really grateful to have a principal like you. We welcome you to this program, dear ma'am. I extend a hearty welcome to our respected vice principal, Dr. Father Xavier C.S. And it is your commitment which creates an app platform for us. Hearty welcome, dear father.
Thank you.
And I take this opportunity to welcome our IQSE coordinator, Dr. Matthew Titelli, NAC coordinator, Dr. Sandhya C, and our course coordinator, Professor Joni Thomas. Welcome, dears. Now, I would like to welcome all the participants. And I know that many of you have made a huge effort to join us today. And it is my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you all. And last but not least, and I welcome all my colleagues and my dear students who have joined us today on this wonderful session. Thank you all and happy webinaring. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for the welcome speech. Next, I would like to invite our respected principal, Dr. Bridget Paul, ma'am, to officially inaugurate this international webinar.
Good afternoon, all.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
The respected resource person of the day, Advocate Abhilash Thomas, Vice Principal of the College, Dr. Xavier Chidantara, IQSE Coordinator of the College, Dr. Matthew Sri Telil, Self-Financing Coordinator, Professor Joni Thomas, Department of Electronics HOD Deepthi, and Sonia NV course program coordinator, and Divya Neetu ED Club coordinators, and all other participants, faculty members, and students. I'm very happy that the Department of Physics with Electronics and Entrepreneurship Club have come up with the webinar on entrepreneurial mindset. We are all born with some unique talents and gifts which can be shared with the entire world for a greater good if you have the right attitude or mindset. It is our mindset that determines the actions that we take. In this modern world, if you have a mindset to absorb inspiration, to get motivated, to stay mentally and physically fit, and if you are ready to face challenges, then the world is yours. While we speak about developing your entrepreneurship skill, we have to think about some other factors also. This includes education and the government in industrial policies, the policies of government. To be literate and to be educated are different, we know. Being educated means not only the ability to read and write, but the ability to develop our skills and facing risks. Another important aspect that would determine the entrepreneurial mindset is the government policy that we have. What comes to my mind is the two recent rankings that came out. One was the literacy rate ranking, and the other one is the ease of doing business ranking. Kerala came first in the literacy ranking and Andhra Pradesh came last. While in the ease of doing business ranking, Kerala was ranked 28th. You know, it is the last but one position in the list, and Andhra Pradesh has grabbed the first rank. We know Kerala is a consumer state. We always feel that Kerala is a backbencher in this sense. It has never been an investment hub, maybe because of the mindset of the people. I would like to conclude by saying that to develop entrepreneurial mindset and motivation for building up a business is the collective responsibility of an individual, our educational system, and also our government. I welcome the eminent resource person advocate Abhilash Mathew. I know this webinar will direct us to develop a mindset which will help us to use our skills effectively. I congratulate the coordinators for taking all the pains to organize the webinar and hereby declare the webinar as inaugurated. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for inaugurating this event. Next, I would like to invite our respected vice principal, Father Xavier CS, to shower us with his words of blessing.
Thank you. Our dear and respected principal, Dr. Bridget Paul, head of the Department of Physics with Applied Electronics, K College, Madanam, Ms. Deepthi S. Nair, Dr. Johnny Thomas, the course coordinator of K College self-financing sector, and the program coordinator, Ms. Sonia NV, and the Faculty of Physics with Applied Electronics Department, and our dear IQAC coordinator, Matthew Stitherly, and our NAC coordinator, Dr. Santhia, and of course, the resource person of the day, Dr. Abhilash Thomas, CEO, Indus Vivah Health Science Private Limited, Bangalore. And my dear faculty members, students, and all the participants of this webinar, a very warm good afternoon to you one and all. I take this opportunity to congratulate and to thank the Department of Physics with Applied Electronics, K College Madanam, I think. This is the second or third webinar they are conducting by different subjects. So I sincerely congratulate and thank them. And of course, I also would like to mention the name of Divya Joseph, the AD Club Coordinator and the Faculty of Commerce Department, K College Madanam. I think they're together jointly arranging and conducting this webinar, I think so. So congratulations to the Department of AD, Department of Commerce Faculty, Dr. Divya Joseph also. So according to Aristotle, happiness consists in achieving through the course of whole life, like one's health, knowledge, friendship, and wealth, etc. And as we all know, entrepreneurship is an activity of setting up a business, taking all financial risk in the outset of profit to make a person happy or to make everybody happy. Being an entrepreneur is very important to be happy in his or her life. And one should bear in mind that this happiness is achieved not in a day, but after great pain and sufferings. So the participants of this webinar, if we work hard, we will achieve a better version of life. In certain times, hard work would not result in complete success. In such times, we have to be optimistic in our life. We may have to choose our own path courageously with true dedication and hope. And to succeed or to become rich is not at all a greed, but it is a way of living that makes us independent. But in order to succeed, we may have to make our own rules in our life. Sometimes we should force ourselves to enjoy a work, and sometimes we have to help our communities by asserting contributions. So I hope and I believe that this webinar will discuss all these matters very well. And let this webinar be a guiding sign for us to the world of success and happiness. I wish you all good luck. And I take this opportunity to once again welcome Advocate Abhilash Thomas to K College community and K College family. May God Almighty bless us all. And may this webinar be a grand success. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Father, for your kind words. Next, I would like to invite our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Matthew T. Telly, sir, to felicitate the occasion.
Very good afternoon and hearty welcome all to KE College Mandanam. Respected Principal, Bridget Pormis, respected Vice Principal for the Dr. Xavier CS, the man of the day, and our eminent speaker, Advocate Abhilash Thomas, respected Jonesar, respected Deepthi Miss, Divya Miss, and Sonia Miss, and all the participants and faculty members. A warm welcome to KE College. As we all know, an entrepreneur mindset is a set of skills that enable people to identify and make most of the opportunities, overcome them, and learn them from setbacks and secured in a variety of settings. It will help a person to live in an organized and a stress-free life. In this pandemic period, such a mindset is very important to all the people all over the world. So it will help to minimize the failures and rejections in our lives. Today, we have with us a best entrepreneur, Advocate Abhilash Thomas, who is the CEO of Indus Viva Health Sciences Private Limited. He got several awards for his business trainings, and he introduced Green Planet Initiatives and Building India 2022 in India. He published a lot of books in these aspects also. During this pandemic period, we are blessed to have such an eminent person with us for encouraging and motivating the young talented mind. He is a friend of our colleague Ms. Sonia, so I congratulate Ms. Sonia of Electronics Department and all his colleagues for bringing such a webinar and such a resource person. So I wish all the very best to all those participants in this webinar. Be this webinar a fruitful one. Have a nice time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for all your support. Next, I'd like to invite our course coordinator, Professor Johnny Thomas, sir, to facilitate the occasion.
Sorry, Johnny sir is not available.
Okay. Next, I would like to invite our program coordinator, faculty from the Department of Physics with Applied Electronics, Ms. Sonia N.V. Ma'am, to introduce our eminent speaker, Advocate Abhilash Thomas sir, Chief Executive Officer, Indus Viva Health Sciences.
Good afternoon. Today, this task of introducing our guest of honor and speaker is a great privilege. We are pleased to welcome Advocate Abhilash Thomas, Chief Executive Officer, Indus Viva Health Sciences Private Limited. I know this one is difficult, but the thought that he is a man of virtue and simplicity. I feel elated to introduce Advocate Abhilash Thomas, sir, the soul of Indus Viva, to everyone today. He is a living inspiration and a role model to all of us. If one takes a closer look at the alchemy of the achieving person, two distinct virtues pop up. These are pioneering spirit and willingness. Advocate Abhilash Thomas. Advocate Abhilash Thomas, Chief Executive Officer of Indus Viva, hails from Sultan Batheri, Wayanad, Kerala. Graduated in law from KLE Law College, Bengaluru. He started direct selling during college to earn his pocket money. As soon as he graduated in 2002, he chose direct selling as his profession and climbed many peaks. And even was moving in a Mercedes at the age of 25. In 2013, the US-based company he was working at decided to wind up its national Indian operations. Along with Mr. C.A. Ansar, a high-profile healthcare entrepreneur, Advocate Abhilash co-founded Indasviva Health Sciences Private Limited in 2014 at Bengaluru. By 2019, it became one among the top 10 direct selling companies in India. Indasviva crossed 500 crores as annual turnover in FY 2019-20. Its manufacturing plant is GMP certified and RRD lab is certified by Department of Scientific and Industrial Research, DSIR, under Government of India. Launched their business in the USA in 2020, the only Indian direct selling company to do so. Indasviva has technical collaboration with Tokyo-based nutraceutical company Bioactive, Japan Corporation for Advanced Product Development. Advocate Abhilash has been awarded by Junior Chamber as the Young Entrepreneur of the Year. During school, he was the state champion for elocution, and during his pre-degree, he won Calcutta University's essay writing event. He was part of the team that won national level championship in Inter-University Youth Parliament competition and received the award from President of India. Advocate Abhilash lives in Bangalore with his wife Didi and three children, Anne, Nora and Joanne. He has brought notable changes in the industry and its standards over the years of green, and is set to move historical. With immense pressure, pride and privilege, I will turn the time over to Advocate Abhilash Thomas, my brother, our eminent speaker. Welcome you, sir.
Can I have a little screen? Little screen. Can I have the screen first? Okay, and then leave it in the show slideshow. Yeah. We'll do later. First, can I have the screen first? Yeah. And good afternoon, everyone. Sorry for the 1 minute which I have lost due to a little technical snag. So, first of all, the principal of Kuriakos Elias College, Dr. Brigitte Paul, Vice Principal, Reverend Dr. C.S. Xavier, IQSA coordinator, Dr. Matthew Titherly, course coordinator, Professor Johnny Thomas, and the one who invited me to this college, Sonia Voges of Department of Physics, and head of the department, Madam Deepthi S. Nair, my dear fellow students. When I got an invitation from Mananam College, actually I was doubting whether they have contacted the right person or not, because KE College is such a prestigious institution, and it belongs to Kottayam district, where so many successful entrepreneurs are living. It is like, I would say, Pala Central Bank. It was the second biggest institution after Government of Kerala in the state of Kerala, then Malayala Manorama MRF Group. Like that, the Kottayam district is known for phenomenal entrepreneurial journeys, and the college has invited a little known person from outside. Anyway, I consider it is a matter of immense privilege, and my heartfelt thanks to the college management, and especially to my friend, Assistant Professor Sonia Voges. I am not I don't even actually know this word, entrepreneur existed. Because my parents, my dad, a farmer, my mother, a housewife, and we grew up in a middle-class mentality. A middle-class mentality in the sense, okay, be happy with whatever you have. Be grateful to that. That is what usually you must be knowing, that what a middle-class mentality is all about. So that is what I experienced during my childhood. And slowly one mindset started developing in me that a middle-class mindset, when I say middle-class mindset, I explained, but followed by certain belief system started developing within me. It is like study well, get good marks, and get into a good job. Your life will be safe and secured. Education is equal to good employment is equal to success. This is the formula what I have got from my family. And after that, I started developing a few beliefs. Number one, limited wealth. I started believing that. Just a sec. Side is not important. Anyway, right. This is fine. This is okay. I started believing that in this world, there is only a limited amount of wealth, a fixed amount of wealth with a cap. That's all it is. We used to say in physics, energy cannot be created or destroyed. I believe in the same theory, the wealth cannot be created. There is only a limited amount of wealth. When somebody started making more and more money, I was believing that actually he is grabbing the share of other people's wealth and making others poor. That way I started developing an anti-capital capitalism mentality. Sometimes I started even thinking to the extent that government should tax the rich to an extent there won't be any rich people in this world. And when people are showing their extravagance or like a Mercedes or that kind of things, it's like when we are waiting for an auto, or even we cannot even afford an auto rickshaw, we are waiting for a public transport to come. That time when some people are moving in a very expensive cars and living in a palace kind of houses, then we started, it's like we get intimidated. Our life is not even worthy to live in this world. That kind of thought process also started actually developing in me. So my belief system was like this before. I was born in a family of farmers, and I have made, or they have designed my life to become an employee. And I started developing hatredness towards the wealthy people. And I believed very strongly that there cannot be a win-win formula to become rich. If someone is losing money, then only you can become rich. Even during my college days, many times I even spoke on stage that government has to make some rules and they have to take the wealth of the rich and give it to poor, distribute among the poor. I believe to that extent. Hope some of you also might have experienced or maybe experiencing similar thought process in life. But end of the day, we can live with this mentality and we can close our eyes and create a darkness. But the reality is not that true. Reality is it is a daylight, it is not dark. So when you are confronting with the reality, you will have so many discomforts. Discomfort number one, especially when you go for a family function, when you have your wealthy cousins out there, you feel like, why I have come here? I shouldn't have come here. That kind of feelings. That discomfort, sometimes I would say, even I have personally faced even humiliation from my rich cousins or my rich friends. So this discomfort, I don't know how many of you are experiencing it today, but one thing I will tell you, if there is no discomfort, you cannot become an entrepreneur. If you have an expensive bike and you have your dad's deep pockets to fill sufficient fuel in it, then it is tough to expect you as an entrepreneur in the days to come. So this is my point to my friends. If you have discomfort, congratulate yourself because you are a potential entrepreneur. Then, as I told, my disparity in wealth and lifestyle made me think of doing something out of my middle class mentality. Then what is the option left? When you look at the options, if you look at the effort to reward ratio, nothing can be at par with entrepreneurship. Nothing can reward you as much as an entrepreneur, an enterprise can reward you. So that way I have decided to become an entrepreneur. This is my story in a nutshell. Here comes the most tragic sentence. It's like, if only I had this kind of capital with me, or if my dad is already running a business, if I have some kind of opportunities like studying in an IIT, so I can start a startup and people are there to fund me up, all those kind of, if I had something, I would have done something. That kind of mentality. Recently, I have seen a Malayalam movie. In that, the hero made one statement that if I had 5 lakh rupee in hand, I know how to multiply it. Since I don't have 5 lakh rupee, I am sitting idle like this at home. If my memory is right, the movie name is Jnan Prakashan. I am not very sure about it. Whatever it is, this is what the most tragic sentence we used to come across. Basically, whenever we think about doing a business of your own, our limiting beliefs like, oh, I don't have capital, I don't have expertise, and what will happen? Whatever money I have, if I encounter with a massive loss, all those things will come in our mind. So basically we are complaining one point that we don't have the resources to become an entrepreneur. See, there is a difference between resource and resourcefulness. Resource and resourcefulness. What is resourcefulness? Resource is outside. What all things I have mentioned, that is all called resource. But resourcefulness comes from inside. These two are two different things. See, resourcefulness is like a mentality to become an entrepreneur. If you look at Gujaratis, unlike Keralites, they all prefer to become an entrepreneur because that is what they are experiencing, that is what they are seeing. And when it comes to Kerala, some people are getting into a business, but you cannot even call it as a business, because there is a difference between business and self-employment. These two are two different things. Self-employment is basically you are owning a job. You are having a 10 by 10 shop, maybe one or two mere staffs. Sometimes even they also may not be there. So a basic setup is, you cannot call it as a business. What will happen, whatever money you earn from it, you used to take it to home and run your house. You know, we cannot blame them for that, because they have to keep their kitchen fire on. So it is not scalable, or they are not even thinking about the scalability part of it. The Forbes magazine explains who is a businessman, who is an entrepreneur. According to Forbes, there are two criteria. Number one, there should be 500 people on your payroll. Means if you have 500 plus employees, criteria number one is met. Criteria number two, if you are out from your business for long 6 months, means 6 months, if you are not attending your office, your business should continue to run with the same smoothness, then you can call it as a business. Otherwise, it's not a business. So mostly when people from Kerala, when they are getting into a so-called business, they don't have a thinking process of making it to a real business from self-employment. So what I'm trying to say, while coming back to our topic, resource and resourcefulness. We blame lack of resources to start a business, but resource is external. Resourcefulness is internal. What is resourcefulness? Resourcefulness is nothing but mindset of an entrepreneur. Mindset of an entrepreneur. What is the mindset of an entrepreneur, and who is an entrepreneur? See, entrepreneurship is a space, where you can actually implement your ideas. If you work in a firm as an employee, even if you work hard, kindly bear with me to use a term called donkey, because there is no other word is coming in my mind. How much ever you work hard, donkey is the one which used to work hard. How much ever you do that, still you have got a master. And what you will be getting? You will be getting only the beatings. So you will not have the freedom to implement your ideas, or you will not have the liberty to be real. You are acting on someone else's behalf. You are implementing someone else's ideas. So that way, it is like a machine life, not a true human life. So for entrepreneurship, the starting point is an idea. See, idea of what? See, India as a country, or Kerala as a state, there are lot many problems existing in our society. Lot many problems. Government of Kerala recently awarded a team of four youngsters. Their company is actually cleaning the drainages. They have developed a machine which will clean the drainages to an extent, even I would say, zero human intervention. Without any human intervention, they clean drainages and even septic tanks previously humans were doing it, the cleaning of the septic tanks. So it is a real problem. Even in this 21st century, human cleaning a septic tank is much below the dignity of human race. So mankind cannot be comfortable when your own siblings are doing a work of that kind. So you need a solution. So they invented a solution. And the government has recognized them, government has awarded them the contract to look after or to drive that particular task. So entrepreneurship is basically like this. There are so many problems in the society. When you are solving the problems, the quality of life of mankind improves. Entrepreneurship is the right mechanism to resolve such issues, because government has limitations. It has to go through the bureaucracy retorpism. By the time it gets the necessary approvals, it will not be relevant for the time. So that way, entrepreneurship is the right way to resolve many of the issues what human beings are facing and making your nation prosper. What Henry Ford did for America. America is a huge country in terms of geography. Centuries ago, their people were living in far distant places. It is like bullock carts and the horse-driven chariots were the only mode of transport on those days. Henry Ford introduced motor cars, or practically a motor car which can be manufactured in size and scale, and connected the people of America. That way it has brought prosperity to United States of America. Otherwise, people were living like islands. One neighbor maybe one day travel away. So the connectivity made by the Henry Ford. So he actually made a major help America to get transformed to what America is today. Same way, if I caught in India, Mr. Mukesh Ambani of Reliance Jio. Reliance Jio is a 4G project. We need to understand the kind of risk that person has taken. He has invested around 4 lakh crore rupee in that project. 4 lakh rupee we know. Crore rupee we know. But 4 lakh crore rupee? Then you will ask, he has that kind of money? No. How he mobilized the funds? He has pledged his inherited property, that is the world's biggest oil refinery in Gujarat. He has pledged those refineries to the Chinese banks. 85% of Jio's funding has come through the loan factor. Balance 15% money only Mr. Ambani has invested. When the Jio came in picture, we need to understand at that time, already India's telecom tariff was the cheapest in the world. Airtel, backed by Singapore government. Singapore government is the biggest stakeholder at Airtel, more than Mittal family. He is one stakeholder in it, Singapore Telecom. Second comes, Tata Group is here. Our own government-supported BSNL is here. World's biggest mobile phone company, Vodafone, was here. Furthermore, the money bag, UAE's, Etisalat, like that there were a dozen players in the market, including his own brothers, Reliance Communications, and many organizations. Already the most competitive market in the country, in the world, sorry. He launched this Jio. He started the preparation in 2010 for Jio and launched the Jio in 2016 with 85% borrowed capital. Just imagine if something goes wrong, like his brother Anil Ambani, he will also has to count his days. Everything will go, the entire inherited properties with a personal guarantee given to the Chinese banks. So he has taken such a big risk and launched Jio in 2016. But he upped the game. It was so disruptive. It was so disruptive. And Jio become successful. I'm not talking about the risk he has taken. I am talking about a simple point. Jio, all Jio customers got benefited by Jio because our mobile bills got slashed to 20%, 25%. Number one. Number two, Jio is not a loss-making company. In spite of giving in such a cheap rate, Jio is still making profit because of their robust business fundamentals. Number three, what impact 4G created in our society? Our society is actually divided in the name of language or region or caste or gender, many, many divisions. But technology is a great leveler. For common man to access technology, there cannot be a better way than high-speed internet at affordable price through a mobile phone. That is what he did. That helped our country to move forward. So when your mobile bill has reduced, your country has benefited, he is also making profit, a total win-win-win formula. So that is what basically an entrepreneurship can do for a nation. Don't be under the impression that only government can change a nation or government institutions can change. No, even private institutions can change. What Ford did for America, Sony did for Japan. Japanese products were considered as a duplicate products. Sony made in Japan only made it built the reputation of Japan as a quality product maker. So whatever it is, if you have an idea, how to create idea, find out, open your eyes, look around. You will find many unresolved problems in your society. Solve it. It will make business sense. And by solving the problem, by making your fellow human beings to prosper, you will get something called profit as a byproduct. Profit is not the main product. If your idea, if profit-centric, I don't think so, it will have a long-term sustainability. It should be a purpose-centric. Okay, you got an idea. What will you do with that idea? $1 million idea? Idea alone cannot make you an entrepreneur. You should be able to influence people, those who have resources. You have an idea. You are a resourceful man. You have to influence a person who has the resources. In my own story, if I tell you, I was working for a US-based company as a direct seller. And in 2013, due to unavoidable circumstances, they had to close down their Indian operations. Suddenly, my income got stopped. My income became zero. I don't know what to do. There are so many people of my friend circle. They also had to encounter the same fate. They all told me, Abhilash, you have to find out a way. The responsibility came to me. If you look at my situation, I am originally from Wayanad district, but I live in Bangalore for many years. My only income source was my direct selling business. If there is no direct selling opportunity, which I can convince my people that this is an opportunity which can be relied on, it will not have the same fate of the previous US company. Even I also pack my bags, have to return to my native, and there I can go and live a comfortable life. Since I have my law degree in hand, I can go and practice in a court in Sultan Batheri. And other resources are available there, make a comfortable living there. It is like I will be compromising in my life. It is like God has given me an opportunity to live in a city like Bangalore. And by giving an excuse of I tried my level best, but still this is my fate, I have to accept it like that. With an excuse, I can go back. But I didn't do that because I'm a strong believer of the idea of direct selling. A strong believer. Because I got many opportunities. One life-changing opportunity, I would say, I could attend a seminar in Hawaii Islands in US, where the top performers of the direct selling industry gathered there. So there I could see how this industry is functioning in other countries. How wonderful it is. That time it was only 2G in India, but it was 4G there in US. I realized today it is maybe a difficult situation in India for this business, but tomorrow India also will have 4G like US. So then this people who stick with this business will have a very wonderful future. So I have seen the future with my own eyes there. So that conviction was so strong with me. So I went and met one very high profile healthcare entrepreneur in Bangalore, Mr. C.A. Ansar. I went and met him. That also, it was actually a surprise because I never met him before. When I was coming out from my church, I could see a board outside. Ona Gosham, Onam celebration of church, sponsored by Olive Life Sciences, a company headed by Mr. Ansar. Then I thought, okay, oh, I know one person from my church who is working for that same company. Okay, let me call him. My brother also told me, just make one call, yaar. If nothing is cracking, we are losing only a call. What is there in it? I called him. I met him. Through him, I met Mr. Ansar. I explained what is direct selling and my 15 years of experience in this industry, what all things I can do in this, how a multi-million dollar organization can be created, the entire blueprint, everything I explained to him. Of course, no one will say yes in the beginning, but repeated attempts, multiple attempts, finally resulted in an yes in it. So later I asked him, sir, what made you to say yes? He said, when I presented this project to my board of directors, surprisingly, Abhilash, I didn't get even a single vote. Everybody voted against this project. They said, already our hands are full. Why we are getting into something new? Hello, please unmute, please mute. All participants, please mute. Yeah, thank you so much for that. So after that, he said, since everybody voted against it, there must be something in it, Abhilash. And I could see your determination and your frequent follow-up, and this made me to say yes. So basically the point is, idea alone cannot make you an entrepreneur. You need an idea and influence. Here you can see idea plus influence. It is not. Let me go back again. Idea plus influence cannot make you an entrepreneur. I repeat, idea plus, no. It should be idea into influence. Idea into influence. Into means it stands for multiplication. It is like you have an idea, a powerful idea, 10 out of 10 idea, and your influencing capability is zero. 10 into zero is equal to your idea also become zero. Like a, what do you call? You are dead even before your birth. So, it is idea into influence is equal to entrepreneurship. If you have an idea and if you can influence, then it is equivalent to entrepreneurship. There are so many people with enough resources. You can somehow reach them out. It is like if your eyes are always opened, you will be able to see lot many, many opportunities. So you can knock those doors. If your idea is powerful, the doors will be opened. Your entrepreneurial journey begins there. This point I have already explained. Many have the belief that business is for profit. Absolutely not. It is not a profit is a bad word. Profit is important. A business without profit is a sinking ship. Profit is important. But an entrepreneurial journey, if you are anchoring on profit, it will not sustain. It should be anchored on a purpose. Anchored on a purpose. If you look at my business, in my business, what are the purposes or what is the main purpose? See, of course, now during this COVID-19 pandemic, people have realized the importance of prevention. Till then, when we talk about prevention is better than cure, it is just a statement. We know the statement, but there was no impact for that statement. But now we know that preventive health is very, very important. But preventive products, it is like even a helmet or a seat belt. If law enforcement agencies are not strong, people are not comfortable or people are not habituate to wear the seat belt or wearing a helmet. So that is the challenge for a preventive product. So advertisements cannot help that. If that is the case with only advertisements, everyone on roads would have been wearing a helmet and seatbelt. The law need not to make the necessary provisions and the enforcement agencies need not to act on it. So basically, the preventive health is very, very, very important. It's like diabetes and many other lifestyle diseases, obesity. These all are quite common in our country. So the best way is to prevent it. So we started making preventive healthcare products and we clubbed it with a direct selling mechanism so that the people can make their customers to understand what is this product all about through explanation and demonstration. And that way, they can ensure that many people are buying these products. Otherwise, if you keep it in your shelf and back to buy Salman Khan's advertisement, it will not be sold. So we have got a clear purpose. Yes, number one purpose, preventive health is a neglected area. Bring it back to the mainstream. And another important purpose, India as a nation, lot of youth people are there, but they don't have enough job opportunities available in the country. For example, I am a graduate in law. There are 25 to 30,000 people are getting graduated in law every year, but country's requirement is only 5,000 people. Then what will happen to remaining 20 to 25,000 people getting accumulated every year? Where they will go? And that will put a pressure on people, those who are already on a job with this, that the first 5,000 lucky category. They cannot ask for a salary increment because outside somebody is waiting there to ready to work with a much cheaper salary than yours. HR will immediately replace you with that fellow. So it is actually putting a pressure on the India's biggest strength is majority of our people are youth. But an unproductive youth is a challenge even for the existence of a nation. And they may get attracted towards organization like Nexalism and all that. So we had a purpose. We must be able to provide entrepreneurial opportunities to a huge number of people, So profit will come as a byproduct. You don't need to focus on profit. You just focus on the purpose. You should not dilute it. Right. See, profit, how the profit comes, basically. People have a mentality that a profit means it is a win-lose. Somebody is losing is the profit of the other person. That typical middle-class thinking, we have to keep it out from our brain. It is that is not true. Let me tell you two scenarios. A middle-class father will give 1,000 rupees to his son and give a bill of his last purchase of stationery items, and he or provisional he will tell go to a provisional store and the same quantity whatever is mentioned in this bill, the same quantity you buy and come, he will give the exact change also to the son. One son returns, he may be giving a 50 rupees a pocket money. Oh, you did so much of hard work, okay, keep 50 rupees pocket money. This is one thinking. A rich class father, what he will do, he will give 1,000 rupee and he will give the bill and he will tell, no pocket money, man. It is up to you to go to different shops and find out where you will get best discount for these products. And such a way, the same quantity with the lesser money, if you purchase, whatever difference is there, that money is yours. First person, he is just like a robot. He will go and buy, come back, pocket money. That is a middle class mentality. The rich class mentality, he will go, he will identify where I will get 1+1 free, where one another option is there. Okay, for Tiger biscuit, I can replace with this biscuit. That is also ITC, equal brand, good one. Okay, like that, he will apply his mind and he will buy the same amount of items of equal quality with a lesser amount. There comes the profit. That is, you need to, when you think about profit, if you make profit in that manner, that profit will sustain. Why people are going to a developer and buying a villa? Because even if you construct the same villa by yourself, since you don't have an experience, you don't have scale, you will have to pay the same amount how much the builder is asking from you. So better buy from the builder. So you will not have any headache of constructing it. For builder, since he is doing 10, 20 villas simultaneously, because of his scale, he will have better bargaining power with the building material dealer, landlord, and his expertise, labor supply. So he will be able to finish it much cheaper than yours, the same quality, and the difference is his profit. So profit comes from where I clearly made you understand. Now comes to another important quality an entrepreneur is required. See, you might have seen the movie in the Apollo 13, in that saving the space travelers, their safe landing back on Earth. The head of the project from Earth given a clear indication that failure is not an option. Failure is not an option. There is no plan B. Failure is not an option. I want those people back to the world. People used to say one point, America is a country is built during wars. Wars made America what America is today. People are thinking America will attack another country and loot their wealth and become rich. That is not true. The truth is, in war times, your life is threatened. When you are in a life-threatening situation, your brain will think or work 8 times faster than a normal situation. Your brain will work 8 times faster than a normal situation. So many new technologies got developed during war times in America, like internet. All those things came to civilian life once the war got over, which made America a very, very wealthy country. Again, another important point is Plan B. This Plan B is a very, very risky game. Plan B is a very risky game because I experienced this Plan B in my life, because before starting this company long ago, I was regularly getting a rental from abroad, a very handful of money. And me and my family could run very smoothly with that rental money. And I realized that rental income made me very lazy. I used to wake up very late. My belt size started increasing. I become a totally lazy guy. So I realized one point, when you have a Plan B, your Plan A will never work, because your Plan B will kill your Plan A. So it is like you as an entrepreneur, for you to get the optimum result, you should not have a Plan B. It is like, if I don't earn from here, my life will go for a toss. That thinking only will give you the additional strength. I would say your brain will start working 8 times faster than a normal situation. So here you need to move. When you have a Plan B, you will be basically in a game zone. You can afford to lose a game, but you cannot afford to lose a war. So if you don't have a Plan B, you are in a war zone. Your best will come out and you will be clearly winning the game. See, in this situation, when you don't have a Plan B, you will ask, you need to be extremely courageous in order to win, in order to become a successful entrepreneur. Absolutely not. If you ask me, I was under tremendous fear. I was under tremendous fear because what will happen if it fails? I will have to go back to my native. And it will become a big humiliation in front of people out there. And people who stood with me for a long time, I am abandoning them. What will happen to their life? See, it is like a company is not basically a building or the, how much money is involved in it. No, company is basically people. It is not the building. The great people creates great companies. That is what I believe. So all those things. In fact, I was blessed with so many great people with me. I cannot name one because there are so many. So I am really thankful to all of them. They actually helped me to overcome my fear. What lesson I have learned? Excuse me, some disturbances coming. If you could mute your... Could you please mute your microphone? Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah. So what lesson I have learned in my life is, fear is not an enemy. Fear is not an enemy. It can be an excitement. It can be an excitement. See, whenever I am under fear, I used to activate an interesting thing. During my, when I was doing my pre-degree, today it is plus two, my times it was pre-degree in Kerala. When I did my pre-degree in my college, the baseline of the college was, with God, nothing shall be impossible. I used to carry that statement all the time with me. Oh, with God, nothing shall be impossible. So when I am under stress or when I am under fear, I used to pray, God, Oh, Jesus Christ, you are such a powerful man, so benevolent, so omnipotent. I am not able to handle the situation by myself, but I am going to face it. I am sure you are backing me with that belief. I am going to address it. I am sure nothing can stand against your mighty power, Lord. So I am taking the step. You be my net. You be my shield. I am going to deal with it. So when, see, we all are mostly double-minded. Every Sunday or any other important day, we go to church or mosque or temple and pray. We pray very seriously. At the same time, we don't have the courage to take up major tasks in life. It's like basically a boy sitting with a fishing rod in a small pond side or a lake side or a river side. And even if he prays to God, God, please take care of my safety, God doesn't have anything to do in that case. What he can do? Anyway, he's sitting in a very safe position. And no whale is going to bite on a fishing rod. First of all, that won't be available in a river. You must give an opportunity for God to act in your life. Take your boats, go to the deep ocean and try to catch a whale. Then if you pray, God, take care of me, make some sense for God. So most of us, actually, it is like a big hypocrisy is running in their mind. One side, they pray to God. Other side, they don't believe in the mighty power of God. So they don't attempt big things by taking God's backup. So for me, I faced my fears, or I defeated my fears with this belief system. And another important point to break the fear is nothing but massive action. Massive action breaks the wall of fear. So massive action is a very, very, very important thing. So when you are confused, when you are ambiguous, your agility is very important. You need to move fast. What will happen maximum? You may fail. Even if you fail, fail faster. If you fail faster, you can start fresh once again. So that way, we can defeat the fear. Many are under the belief system that failure is something which we must avoid in life. Understand, dear friends, every time you cannot win. Because somehow in our school days, we got this belief system that failure is something which we must avoid in life. We say, we know what is the opposite of north, it is south. We know what is the opposite of success, that is failure. This is what we have learned from school. But actually, that is not true when it comes to entrepreneurship. It is, failure is a part of success. You need to fail many times to succeed once. It is like, if you are not willing to fail, and if you are thinking failure must be avoided, then you cannot enjoy success. So success is something like a precious metal of gold. But in order to get that, you need to wash tons of dirt. The tons of dirt is your failures. You don't need to avoid failure. And every decision of yours not necessarily will be right every time. So I'm sitting here as a chief executive officer, but I'm not assuring anybody that all the decisions I am taking will be right. But the intentions behind all the decisions are right. I may make wrong decisions. I am not supernatural to avoid wrong decisions. I may make wrong decisions, but intentions are right. And if I found that a decision is wrong, I will have to correct it at the earliest. So that is the way it is. So fear is not an enemy. Let's take fear is an excitement and massive action, and faith in God breaks the wall of fear. Again, the same point, no risk, no reward. See, no risk, no reward in the sense, see, why people are not ready to start their own business? Because of the risk involved in it. Or in this scenario, you can say, basically risk means losing your investment. So in this scenario, you are activating a man with resource. You have the resourcefulness. So that way, your financial risk is not there. Then some people say, sir, you said idea and influence. I don't have any idea coming in my mind, sir. Then how can I influence others? Then you are one of my category. Let me tell you, there was no idea coming in my mind after my college. There was zero idea in my mind. But as I said in the beginning, I don't want to be a middle class anymore, because I don't want to be intimidated in my life anymore. So the highest rewarding is entrepreneurship. Otherwise, you should be extremely talented like Virat Kohli or A.R. Rahman. That is all are exceptional cases. Exceptions are not examples. So then the only way is entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship, then no idea. I am not a techie guy who has many ideas. Then what to do? That is the reason I have selected network marketing or direct selling as my career. It is a wonderful idea, but not my idea. But with that idea, I can influence others. And I can take somebody else's help also to influence others. So that is the reason I chose direct selling and network marketing as my career path. So basically, never attempted to get a job after my education. That is the bottom line. And I don't regret about it till date. See, 70% of the Ivy League universities passed out, those alumni opts entrepreneurship above employment. You know, the Ivy League status, they are the best brains all over the world, but only 30% are looking for an employment. So basically, it is like, what do you say? You are an eagle. The God has created you with a strong wings. When you have strong wings, you don't need to worry about the strength of the branch of a tree. Even if you sit on the branch of a tree, you are not bothered about the strength of it, because your dependency, your belief system is on your own wing strength. That is the point. When we have got wings, we must fly. We must fly. So I don't want to go with a corporate job. There you need to climb the corporate ladder. I don't believe in that, because you don't need to climb the ladder when you have the wings. So, and just a terrace is not your destination. Your destination should be the blue sky, because you have the helicopter in your hands. So that way, dear friends, it is the no risk means it is like basically the willingness to take a calculated risk will reward you very, very heavily, dear friends. If you don't even attempt, I can see even in my office, when I look at one day the profile of my each department heads, each one is much more competent than me. And I used to tell them that if you're not more competent than me, there is no point. I need to hire you. I need people around, those who are more competent than me, those who can teach me something, those who can give me ideas. It is not only one brain working in this company. No. You department heads, it is like you are kind of entrepreneurs. When I hire my top people, I never hire a person. Even if you look at any Fortune 500 companies, they won't hire a person who has only an employee mentality. It is like a 9-to-5 mentality. Today, it is not how many hours you work, your output matters. It is not a person who is fully involved only in the transactions. the daily dealings. No, I want my department heads to be free. I don't want to them to be busy with the transactions. I want them to be free. They just need to look at only the escalations. Their mind should be free. Then only they can think. If they think, then only the organization will grow. So even it is like basically my mindset was I don't want to be on the strong branch of a government job or an MNC company with my weak wings. So if you ask me what is my success secret, this is what it is. So what is my request to you is today, entrepreneurial attitude is not limited only in a business. If you are a person with an entrepreneurial attitude, then you will be running your company's one of the divisions as if you are the owner of it. You own it. So that attitude is very, very important. See, let me tell you, this we have explained. So don't look at the strength of the branch, like government job or even a MNC job. No, trust the strength of your wings. See, even Saint Chavara was a monk. He was a spiritual leader. At the same time, he had an entrepreneurial attitude, and as a result, the CMI institutions across the globe is enriching lives. So that is an entrepreneurial thinking. That is an entrepreneurial thinking. So even you need an entrepreneurial thinking to become even a saint, not to become only an entrepreneur. So that way, dear friends, even if you are looking for a job, but you need an entrepreneurial thinking. I explained what is entrepreneurial thinking and what are the main characters of it. See, you know, NASA is one of the most, the finest organizations in the whole world. NASA will not hire an engineer or a person who has not gone through a failure in life and overcome that failure. If you are a cliche BTech MTech, then worked for some good companies for some time, apply for a job in NASA, no, you won't get it. You have to face some challenges and you must fail. And after the failure, if you have arisen, if you are arisen, then you are selected. Otherwise, NASA will not hire you. So, furthermore, we have launched our business in the US. We are the first company from India launched a direct selling business in the US. Direct selling has got 26 years of history in India, but we are the first company. Even in India, if you look at top 10 direct selling companies, it's a list mostly dominated by American and Scandinavian companies. So when an Indian company is going to the US, actually in the industry, it was a big discussion, at least for some people, we were a laughing stock. Indian company competing in the world's biggest and most competitive market? Our answer to them was this photograph. Gentlemen, we know swimming very well, so we don't care about the depth of the ocean. So if you know the trade very well, then the sky is your limit. You can go and compete anywhere in the world. We used to say, if you defeat Usain Bolt in a sprint, then you don't need to compete with any Tom, Dick and Harry. So the same way, if you flex your muscles in the US, then you don't need to prove yourself in any other market in the world. If you ask me, was my journey was so easy? Absolutely not. I had faced a lot of adversities to the core I have faced. My people have faced, my family has faced to the core. Still, I stayed back because I believe a diamond will shine only after rubbing. These adversities are actually rubbing me to make me the most appropriate person for tomorrow. So with that spirit, I took it. And most of the time, in the first level of resistance itself, people used to give up. Please don't do that. One most important entrepreneurial quality is you need to be you need to have a belief that you will land successfully. It is like a pilot. 90% of the time he goes out of the track, but finally he will land that aeroplane exactly on such a small runway. So that optimism is a very important quality for an entrepreneur. Entrepreneurship is not something if all the lights are green, you can proceed. It is not. Please keep that in mind. See, now it is like we used to see many daydreams. Somebody, a lazy boy with a small fishing rod, expecting a whale. We should not be like him, dear friends. So basically, this is my final point. People want security in their life, and people want freedom in their life. That is the reason people go for a job security. Job security, that word comes along with the job. But who has the highest security? The highest security, if you look at a person who is in jail, has the highest security, but he has the least freedom. He has the least freedom. So please understand, security and freedom cannot come together. Security and freedom cannot come together. So you decide which one you want to embrace, security or freedom. So India, we all have commitment to our nation. We want our nation to progress. Only way our nation can progress by having so many entrepreneurs. India requires not just one Reliance or one Tata. India requires so many Reliance, so many Tatas, so many Infosys. India requires so many of such kind of organizations. That is the only way India can prosper and poverty can be eliminated from our country. So the country is looking at you. So please throw away your middle class mentality and be an entrepreneurship. By being an entrepreneur, you shall become the master of your life and you shape your own destiny. So and you are freedom and your choices what you make. And Narayan Murthy kind of entrepreneurs, they make they live in a very humble way. They live in a very humble way in spite of being a billionaire. So for them, wealth is something different. So that is a choice they have made, but it's absolutely up to you. So finally, why you have to become an entrepreneur? To leave your own legacy. We all will die one day, but the brand we create, if that brand exists, then we shall live even beyond our demise. Boeing, we used to say Boeing. Boeing is a brand. Boeing is a company founded by, founder's name was Boeing. Ford is a company founded by Ford. So the same way, by leaving a legacy, you can elevate your family status from middle class to upper class. Then after many generations, your great grandchildren will remember, my great great grandfather Mr. X actually lifted our family from middle class to rich class. We all are indebted to him. It is like you are moving from 1 to 9, not from 1 to 2. So for leaving a legacy also, you have to become an entrepreneur. So I got time till 4 o'clock. Over to the master of the ceremony.
Thank you, Abhilash sir. Massive action, break the fold of fear. Beautiful Scott. It was an awesome session, sir. We had a great time with you, Abhilash sir. I express my sincere gratitude to you, sir. We will go ahead and take some time for questions. Just a reminder, please be sure to type questions into the chat box or unmute your audio.
Participants, please use this opportunity to ask your valuable questions to our guest, Abhilash sir. Also, the feedback form is made available in the chat box. Kindly fill in your details and comments. Sir, there are some questions in the chat box.
All right.
Hello, sir.
Could you please read it out for me?
Okay. Sir.
Please.
Sir, what is the next revolution industry? Nidhul Nair.
See, if you ask me, there is a very, very high potential for so many industries. Of course, health and wellness is going to be on the center stage. Why? Because the world in the coming years will be able to see people are going to live for 80 years, 100 years, even beyond 100 years. So such kind of supplements are under development in various countries. So there will be huge demand for such kind of products. So that way, health and wellness will take the center stage of it. Of course, the digital technology will have a great future, undoubtedly. It's like alternative energy, not the fossil fuels. Like that, there are so many industries which will have a great future.
Okay, thank you. Sir, what is the most important skill that an entrepreneur needs? Is the set all factors of production is must in case of an entrepreneurship?
What is the most important quality an entrepreneur requires? After that, you said one more thing.
Is the set all factors of production is must in case of an entrepreneurship?
No. See, let me answer the first part. See, the most important quality an entrepreneur requires is tenacity. His tenacity is very, very important. It is like, what do you say? He should stand strong. He should be self-motivated. You cannot motivate. You cannot stand with a motivation coming from from outside. It is like a tire. If there is no engine connected, that tire cannot roll for long. It will stop and fall. So if it is internally motivated, he will be like the tire of a car. When the engine on, the tire on. That is the way it is. So the tenacity is the most important quality a person requires in order to successful, in order to become successful as an entrepreneur. Coming to the second part, the production, absolutely not. Today's world is of full of asset light model. The heavy asset organization like General Electric General Motors or Tatas are not the poster boys of today's world. Today it is Apple or Microsoft. They all are asset light organizations. So it's like you need to have the formulation with you. You can even get the manufacturing done through a contract manufacturing and all that. Absolutely not.
Sir, would you please tell something about direct selling?
See, direct selling is basically a company is marketing a product without using the intermediaries like national stockist, C&F agent, super stockist, retail store, advertisements. All these things will be replaced with independent direct sellers. They buy the product directly from the company and they give it to the customer directly through explanation and demonstration. So whatever you sell, you will get the profit. Number one. Number two, you can also appoint so many direct sellers in your organization and you can create a network, and whatever turnover is happening in the network, from that you will get a supervisory commission. These are the two ways you make money in a direct selling business. And don't be under the impression that you need to be a kabuliwala, you carry the product to a party's house. Absolutely not. That era is gone. There are beautiful videos you can send to the party. If party likes it, then you can send the purchase link. Party can place the order online through courier. He will be getting the product at his doorstep.
Thank you, sir. How one can excel in the advertising industry? How advertisements can be helpful to run a business?
See, I don't know much about advertisement because I don't have any connection with that. But the branding, of course, branding is a very important thing. If you want to get into a business of that kind, your branding is very important. It should start from your personal branding. Basically, you need to be when you talk about your personal branding, you need to be a man of no-nonsense, and your character should be predictable. Otherwise, people cannot work with you. So these are the few aspects you can do about a personal branding. So that way, that much only I can answer about it, because that is not my area of expertise.
Sir, how to deal with the middle class mindset effectively? Is there any psychological tools?
It is really a sad state of affairs, because we all grow in an environment because our atmosphere influences our attitude. Neighbors, friends, relatives, everybody is tuned to become an employee, get for a job. So number one and number two, be happy with what you have. All those kind of philosophies are actually embedded. So it is like we have to take a conscious effort.
Hello.
I think so. Good, sir. Good.
Some technical issue.
Yes. Wait.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sorry, there was a drop in the network. Yeah. So So what I'm trying to say, in order to develop, in order to come out from the middle class mentality, you have to bulletproof yourself from the external factors, and internal factors, you have to consciously take efforts to do that. I gave you a few things like reading positive thinking books, taking part of organizations like Business Network International or Junior Chamber, or attending the training programs on leadership and business excellence and all those things. You need to spend some resources on it. You have to invest in yourself.
Okay, so next question. Has your low background helped you through the entrepreneurial journey?
See, my legal background, I would say, it helped me because since I am a first generation entrepreneur, whenever a notice is coming from the government or whenever I have to meet the government officials and all that, it is like our current system, if they want, they can trouble you for sure. So at that point of time, of course, my legal background actually helped me to gain my confidence and face the adversities. It definitely helped. But if you ask me, minus this law degree, this would have been achieved? Yes, I will still say yes. That is my strong belief. But it is always an added advantage. Your journey can be shorter if you have an MBA in hand or an LLB in hand, a degree which is relevant to your domain. It will definitely help. A graduation level. I cannot comment on the post-graduation level. I think post-graduation level is a bit overdose, I believe.
Okay, thank you, sir. It was very inspiring and thought-provoking. Now, due to time constraints, we are moving on to the next section. Now, I'd like to invite Ms. Divya Joseph, ma'am, faculty from Department of Commerce and also ED Club coordinator, for the vote of thanks.
Most respected principal of the college, Dr. Brigitte Paul, vice principal, Dr. Xavier C.S. CMI, resource person of the day, Advocate Avalash Thomas, IKC coordinator, Dr. Matthew T. Telly, head of the Department of Applied Electronics, Ms. Deepthi, self-financing course coordinator, Professor Johnny Thomas, webinar coordinator, Ms. Sonia, and our most valued participants. We all know that entrepreneurs play a vital role in economic development. Entrepreneurs serve as the catalyst in the process of industrialization and economic growth. No entrepreneurs can succeed without the right mindset. The international webinar on entrepreneurial mindset was a humble attempt to critically analyze how entrepreneurial mindset helps an entrepreneur to identify and make the most of opportunities, overcome or make use of the challenges. I hope that this webinar has helped the participants in realizing the need for forming right entrepreneurial mindset from the rich entrepreneurial experience of our resource person. Now, let me come to the duty entrusted upon me. First of all, the resource person of the day, Advocate Avalash Thomas, an entrepreneur and a good speaker, he has shared his own life experience and expertise as an entrepreneur. We have got the apt person to discuss on this topic, entrepreneurial mindset. Sir, we are gratified to you for finding time for this webinar in spite of your busy schedule as an entrepreneur. I, on behalf of the College, IQAC, Electronics Department, Organizing Committee, and ED Club of the College, we convey the sincere gratitude to you, sir. Thank you, sir.
That's right.
Next, Dr. Brigitte Paul, the captain of KE College, who has been inspirational guidance and encouragement in all our programs. Madam, on behalf of all the participants and Organizing Committee, we express our sincere gratitude for you, for your presence and support. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Dr. Xavier C.R. CMI, our Vice Principal of the College. The very presence of Reverend Father Xavier C.R. CMI is a reflection of his affection and concern towards the initiatives of each department of this college. Dear Father, We are really thankful to you for the gracious presence and support. Next, I extend my thanks to Team IQAC, especially to the coordinator of IQAC, Dr. Matthew T. Tilley, for the enormous cooperation towards conducting this webinar effectively. Thank you, sir. On behalf of our organizing committee, I also appreciate the efforts and guidance of the self-financing course coordinator, Professor Johnny Thomas. Thank you, sir. Next, the perfect support and cooperation extended by the Department of Applied Electronics is really appreciated. Thanks to all faculty members of the department, and special thanks to Head of the Department of Electronics, Ms. Deepthi. Thank you, Ms. Being the convener of the webinar, Ms. Sonia has taken all pains behind the conduct of the webinar. A very dedicated and motivated convener. On behalf of all, I express the appreciation and gratitude to dear Sonia, Ms. Thank you, Ms. I also take this opportunity to extend our most sincere thanks to all our dear participants for their active participation and support. I also express the sincere gratitude to all the faculty members of the organizing department and to team members of ED Club and IQAC for their valuable suggestions and cooperation. Let me conclude my words of gratitude by thanking God Almighty for all the blessings to make this event a successful one. Once again, thank you all. Have a nice day.
We have come to the end of this internet.
Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you. Have a great rest of the day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your webinar.
Thank you, Abla, sir.
Most welcome. Thank you, the college.